Alrighty then. On to the next objective. I think we want to go over this way. Because we are far from done here. I believe, let's see. We want to go... Where do we want to go? I don't want to say I'm not too familiar with this level, but it's not like a level that I instantly remember where everything is. You know, it's not... I don't have that kind of an experience with it. Aha! Here we go. There's something. Alright, we are racking... We are racking up dragon eggs here like something crazy now. Just two more eggs to grab, and both of those eggs are in the same area. Excuse my coughing, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, we want to go back over here because there is another area for us to do, and we want to kill all the crab! I'm having crab legs tonight! Deadliest Catch, eat your heart out. Even though that is a good show. One of the few good shows left on Discovery Channel. But, that's off topic. Don't want to go on a tangent, if you know what I mean. Even though I'm very good at going off on tangents. Like, if I start talking about something, I'll completely lose the meaning of whatever I'm supposed to be doing, and I'll just start rambling like crazy. Apparently a lot of people don't have a... Apparently a lot of people don't actually have a problem with that. Let's see, I don't think... Well, I do want to go back over here real quick. Because there is a gem container up in that little alcove. And the only way to break it is with this particular cannon. That's the sound I want to hear. Go back over here. Up the whirlwind we go. And go over here. Go into here, and up the whirlwind! Alright, and glide, hover, land. Now that, a round number, but... I don't think we quite have all the gems. We might be maybe, let's see, probably about 100 short. Like, I'm doing the trick to find gems and Sparks is not pointing out anything. So I think we're gonna have to go to the area that has the last, two dragon eggs. Whoa. What am I doing? I'm lost. I don't know, maybe I shouldn't have been so eager to jump back into recording. Either that or maybe I should have planned out my route a little bit better because this is... I'm taking up some time doing this level. I think at this point I will have already split the episode into two. But, you know, regardless of that, here's the second warp door for this stage, so let's go inside. And what is this? Rhynocs on skateboards and Hunter also with a skateboard. What could this mean?
Spyro, you're just in time. A Rhynocs skateboard gang has challenged us to a race. They said you're slower than a molten crater fire slug. I stuck up for you, though. I told them I've seen some pretty fast fire slugs.
Well, thanks for sticking up for me, I guess.
So, are you ready to race these guys? They bet us an egg that you won't win.
I'll be willing to take up on that bet, although this is one of the more, this is potentially one of the more difficult eggs in the game, but we're gonna give it a shot.
Right on! You can use my special racing board. Every time you do a trick, it builds up turbocharge. You can use your turbos at any time by pressing the square button. Good luck!
Alright, do tricks to get turbos. Use turbos by pressing the square button. Beat all Rhynocs in a three-lap relay... Wow, I butchered that last sentence. Beat all Rhynocs in three-lap race. There we go. Yes, I can talk. It's just a little difficult for me sometimes. So yes, the skateboard mechanic is back. However, instead of doing tricks for points, we are racing. And in order to win this race, we have to come in first after three laps. And doing tricks will allow us to build up turbo boosts. And we can also get turbo boost by using blue boost stars, like in the speedway levels. And we also have special red rockets that we can use to launch at the Rhynocs to shoot them down and have a chance to gain the lead. And we can also run into them to wipe them out. So what do you think about that, sir? So it's once again time to show off my mad skills, much like I did in Enchanted Towers and Sunny. Oh snap! Me and my big mouth. I was trying to go for that out of the way tunnel, but I guess I got a little too cocky. I've said it before, ladies and gentlemen. When I get cocky, the game brings me back down to earth. It's like, oh, you're confident now, huh? Let's fix that. But I still got mad skills, cause I'm about to win, baby! Yeah! How do you like me now?
Yes! You schooled them like a bunch of dizzy one-toed sand norks. Oh yeah, I guess we won this egg, too.
Getting a little into it, aren't you, Hunter? But we ain't done here yet.
Now that the Rhynocs are gone, do you want to try a real challenge? I know you're fast, but I bet you can't defeat all the crabs on the course and still beat me in a race. Want to give it a shot?
Yep. It's another Hunter challenge, and this time we gotta race him with an added stipulation. And let's just say this one isn't gonna be quite as easy, potentially. But yeah, we're gonna do it. You're on, pal.
Alright! Eat my skate dust, sucker!
Oh, you're cocky, aren't ya? Like, I swear, they made Hunter... Hey, I got a skill point! Don't remember how, I think it's because I actually beat a time. Like, yeah, there's a record time for this racing challenge, and if you beat it, you actually do get a skill point. So, yeah, we just knocked off the skill point. What do you think of that, ladies and gentlemen? Now, in addition to beating Hunter, we also have to take out all these random little crabs that are on the track, which is a very arbitrary and unnecessary condition that can really inflate the difficulty a little bit. And that's sort of a criticism I have. Like, I mean, why do we have to do something so arbitrary like kill crabs? Like, this challenge can be difficult enough, at least for a first-time player. just having to race Hunter, because Hunter is rather... Oh, come on, I pressed the jump button to get extra height there. Give me a break. Oh, boy. Okay, down to one crab, and I know where it is. Maybe I don't. Oh, crap. Dang it. Okay. Let's see. Jump. 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 Okay, got the crab. Let's go, Hunter. You and me, baby. Oh, wow. This is gonna take... What? That didn't count as a trick? Come on. Ah, he got me. I know when I'm beat, and he beat me right there.
Now that the Rhynocs...
So again, I guess to explain why I'm doing this level first before Frozen Altars like I usually do, back in episode, I believe it was episode 22, when I visited Sunny's Honey Speedway, I talked about doing that level right off the bat because of a Hunter challenge. And I talked about how after a certain point in the game, Hunter actually becomes unavailable. And that applies here as well. So that's also why I'm doing this level right now, so I can get the Hunter challenge out of the way. Because after a certain point in the game, Hunter will become unavailable, you know, for you to do certain challenges with. So I'm trying to make the game as convenient for me to do as possible. Why did I go this way? There was no need for me to go that way. Holy crap! I'm going nuts! Somebody stop this crazy dragon! Crap, I missed a crab. Yeah, this one's a bit more difficult than the Rhynocs one.
Now that the Rhynocs are...
Again though, why this stupid stipulation? Yeah, we'll make you race this fast cheetah on a skateboard. But also, you gotta kill 10 crabs. Why? That's just stupid. Like, I don't get it. Were they running out of ideas? Really? Could they have come up with something else? Something better. Whatever, I'm not a game designer. Alright, down to one crab. Like, okay, like, the thing is, the key here, which is what I'm trying to demonstrate on this attempt, you want to take out the crabs first. Worry about Hunter later on. Try to take out all the crabs on the first lap or so, and then focus on beating Hunter. Jump! Come on, baby, we're gonna make it this time. What? Okay, then. No comment. What, did the crab sidestep at the last second? Like, see ya, sucker! You ain't getting me. You, sir, are going to pay dearly. Crap. I may have lost again. I can't believe I pulled that trick off. Come on, baby. Let's go, baby. Come on. Hit that crab. Yes. 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 Eat it.
Sheesh. I can't believe you beat me. You must have been practicing the whole time I thought you were looking for eggs. Hey, speaking of which, one of those crabs was guarding this one.
Just give it to me. Man, got anything to say for yourself?
You might be able to beat me at skateboarding, but I still get all the chicks.
So do I, Hunter. Have you been paying attention to Spyro 2? You know, me and Alara, you know? Even though Spyro is clearly not the romantic type, but, whatever. Now, of course, I have to go back through here because there are some gems that I gotta grab. I think I only have to grab, like, one little gem container, though. Nope. They were up there, I guess. Well, let's see. One right there. One right there, and... oh, really? Really? You're gonna do... aha! Alright, 600 gems. And Lost Fleet is done. That means that we can get out of here. Finally. This recording is about to pass 41 minutes. So this is definitely two parts. I think things went well here, you know? I mean, other than the problems with, you know, the hunter race, I mean, this didn't go so bad. I think it went pretty well for my first time back recording after at least 2 weeks. Anyway, we are done. Treasure, and we have 91 dragon eggs. I feel good. So let's get some fresh air. And Atlas time. So go down right here to Lost Fleet. We've got all 6 dragon eggs and all 600 gems. That's right, we now have 600 gems per level in Evening Lake. So Lost Fleet is officially done all the way through, and that bumps our totals to 8,500 gems collected and 91 dragon eggs for 59% completion. And we are officially going to stop here. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon for the PlayStation 1. We have officially knocked off Lost Fleet, our first main level of Evening Lake. And in the next episode, we will go on to the next main level of the game, which will be Frozen Altars. But you're going to have to wait until the next episode to see that. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. And I'll see all of you in the next episode. See you folks later. Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it. And also, don't forget to like me on Facebook.